श्रीकृष्णा 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 श्रीकृष्णा। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। We begin anything with many supports. Support is alamban. Like when a child starts walking in his life, he takes many supports. First, he is walking on his stomach. Then that is not enough. Then he takes the four legs, knees and hands. That is not enough. Then he takes the support of the wall, the curtains, and slowly he learns how to stand. Many supports. And as he grows, the supports are left, and then he is able to walk straight without any support. Exactly the same way. First of all, we require various supports. So, tabla, peti, and then different singers. So that we can get attracted towards something or the other. From that, we drop that. Then we come to only one mantra. Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. That is continued. Then afterwards, that also gets dropped. Then we are holding on to the silence. Ultimately, this support of the silence, that is also dropped. And we come to that which is supporting both the sounds and the silence. So this is the supportless recognition of one's being. This is what Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi says, that ajyadharaya srotasa samam sarala chintanam viralataha param. Ajyadharaya means like the flow of ghee or any oil. If we pour water, there is never a smooth flow of water when it falls from a height. There are breaks in between. The drops come out here and there. But when you pour the oil, it's a smooth fall and it's straight away continuous. So, ajyadharaya samam. Let there be unbroken recognition of the purpose of our life. That is important. The unbroken purpose. We are in this world only for one purpose. And the purpose is we become an instrument through which the divine expresses in its full glory. Forget about seeing God and God realization. Don't get lost in that. Bhagavan Sri Krishna says in the 6th chapter, only 2 things are necessary, not the third. Number 1, Shita Ushna Sukadukheshu Jitatmanaha. When the complementary pairs of opposite, they dash us. Many people translate the dvandva as pairs of opposite. I don't like that translation. It's not pairs of, they are not opposed. They are complementary to each other. If there is no death, life has no value. If there is no poverty, riches have no value. If there is no disease, health has no value. They complement each other. They are not opposed. So when these sukha, dukkha, joy, sorrows, heat, cold, good, bad, this is how the world comes to us. When this way the world comes, what is our interaction? Jitatmanaha. Equanimity of our mind is not compromised for anything. Most important thing in the whole universe is our equanimity of mind. Before we take up anything, mind is equanimous. When the things are performed, mind is in the same state. When the job is over, mind is untouched by all that is done. That is the ultimate. So this is the first step. This is called as 50% God realization. Shita Ushna Sukhadukheshu Jitatmana. So the things come to us in the form of these opposites. Beings, people, they come to us in two ways. Manapa mana yoho. Somebody respects us, somebody doesn't respect us. Manapa mana yoho prashantasya. When somebody respects, we don't have to climb on a tree. And when somebody disrespects, we don't have to take a plunge into the waters. These two things put together is called as Paramatma Samahitaha. Attainment of unity with the divine. And therefore, Ajadharaya Srotasasamam. It has to be a continuous process. Not even fraction of moment, we forget about it. And the second quality given, Srotasasamam. Srota means a river that is flowing. When the river flows, there is no effort on part of the river to flow. Oh God, I had to change the gear. No. River flows effortlessly. So these are the two qualities of the sincere plunge into the divine. One is mind is equanimous, and second is mind is tuned to the divine continuously and effortlessly. So between these two, sarala chintanam viralataha param. Initially, it will not happen. See? These grandfathers are more attached to the world than the parents or the children. See? So, one grandfather was telling me, Swamiji, have you seen that Sri Krishna serial? I said, I have seen the original one. Why will I see the duplicate? No. You know, when I saw that serial and when Bhagavan Krishna is shown on the screen, I was remembering my grandson. From the sublime to the ridiculous. See, by looking at your useless child, you should remember God. But by looking at the divine, you remember a useless child. See? So initially it will not happen. Therefore, virala, it is not continuous. But never mind. Slowly it will come. And ultimately it will mature into sarala chintanam, effortless. Morning also I told you, effortlessness is an expression of divinity. How much effortless it should be? This is another question which we come across. Swamiji, how much time it will take for me to realize? So when he asked me this question, I asked him, are you married? He said, why do you ask this question? I said, don't question my question. You simply reply, are you married, yes or no? He said, yes, I am married. I said, then why are you so guilty? And tell me, how do you know I am married? I said, from your face. Face of a married person can be seen even by a blind person. All kinds of funny questions people ask us. In one place in Pune, these people come with a .com now. So, one lady came with a very big one. So, she was conspicuous in the whole thing. So, I asked her, I said, Amma, your .com is very big. What is the criteria of your sizes of the .com? She said, Swami, you don't know such simple things. I said, please educate me, you are my guru. He said, the size of the .com is directly proportionate to the love for the husband. Bigger the .com, more the love. Lesser the .com, less the love. Lesser the .com, little is the love. And no .com, Ram Krishna Hari. See? Therefore, ladies have to have the sign. But then why not gents? Gents can be recognized without sign. Yaar bichara, shadi shuda hai. Don't require any special thing. As much makeup the ladies do, gents don't. So, sarala chintanam virlataha param. Relax. It is effortlessness in life. And that effortlessness is how much? So that person I asked, how much time and effort will you take, you the husband, to be the man? How much time it takes for the husband to become man? How much time it takes or how much effort it takes for the husband to become man? Zero. And man can become the husband. Husband can never become the man. Because he's already a man. He doesn't have to become. We don't have to become divine. We are. See? How the man becomes the husband? He sacrifices his freedom and takes the mirror of the wife and looks into that and mistakes that reflection is me. So is the reflection real or your face is real? Is the man real or the husband real? And who is miserable? Never the man and ever the husband. See friends, when we recognize these principles, we'll play the game of life without getting influenced by the ups and downs. So, sarala chintanam virlataha param. Now, this is still continuing with the sense of duality. So, bheda bhavana sohamityasau bhavana bhida pavanimata. So, initially, the seeker, I, the seeker, and God, the sort. So, this is very important thing. Be very attentive. Every intellectual is lost in objectifying the subject. Because when we study in our sciences, material science, everything is known only objectively. So, we know only one way. Objectification is the foundation of knowledge in our understanding. One day, one Bengali boy asked me this question. Swamiji, have you seen God? I said, why should I tell you? No, not that way. Vivekananda also asked the same question to Bhagwan Ram Krishna Paramahans. Therefore, I am asking you. I said, you may be Vivekananda. I am not Ram Krishna Paramahans. Then I told him, my dear, when you ask the question, have you seen God? First of all, you tell me, what do you mean by God? We use the words without any meaning. Words without meaning is noise. While talking, suppose in between suddenly, and therefore my friend, if I do like this, what will you say? What happened to Swamiji suddenly? Because this has no meaning. In the same manner, aham brahmasmi, aham, I don't know. Brahma, I don't know. Asmi, I don't know. Om namah shivaya, om, I don't know. Namaha, I don't know. Shivaya, I don't know. So what is om namah shivaya, aham brahmasmi? See, any topic you take in our scriptures, any topic, every topic is aimed at bringing us back to our essential nature. The theories of creation in the fourth chapter of Panchadashi, there are about 7-8 theories of creation as given in the Upanishads are mentioned. And it is concluded, all these theories of creation are not meant to discuss creation. They are not meant to prove creation. They are meant to bring your attention to yourself. See, our thinking approach has to be subjective. One day a small little girl, she asked me, she said, Swamiji, when the world is created and where from the world begins and where the world ends? So I asked her, I said, hey, you are so sweet, so intelligent. Who asked you to ask me this question? Mummy. Such dumb questions are never asked by the children. Then I told her mother, Mama, why don't you ask? Swamiji, I am afraid of you. I say, I am a vegetarian. I don't eat people. Then I told her, the world is created that moment when we are identified with our body. The world begins from our gross body. If we are not identified with the body, this world doesn't exist for us. Where are we in deep sleep? What are we in deep sleep? When are we in deep sleep? Time, space, and object, they are created the moment there is body identification. See? And therefore, here the teacher says, Bheda Bhavanat, in comparison to keeping the Bheda, the otherness, initially we have to begin that way only. Because we are buried under the burden of the Upadhi, the body identification. Therefore, okay, as long as you think you are a body, you require a God with a form. And see how these subtle things are. When we go to the Lord, go to the temple, close our palms together, eyes, and do namaskar. You have come all the way, and why you are closing your eyes? See, because all of us unknowingly know the truth is not outside. That is our essential nature. So initially, yes, Bheda Bhavana. Ultimately, Saha Aham Iti Asau. This Japa Soham or Ham Saha. The Japa is not meant for only giving the name to the children. Many people name their child as Soham. And they call Soham Udbeta. And that dumbo doesn't get up. See? Soham is a mantra. It is not a name of somebody. Saha, he, aham, I am. There is no difference between me and the Lord. Be attentive. When the object, let's take Rasagulla, is in the plate, and the instrument by which we taste the Rasagulla, the sweet meat, is our tongue. As long as they are separate, object is Sat, existence. Tongue is Chit, the knowledge. They are separate. So we are waiting for the prayer to be over. In many places they chant the 15th chapter and they are so frustrated. Jaldi karna, Om Rono. And then Brahma Prana Brahma Brahma. Finish it off. Why? You want to lift that dirty thing and land on your tongue. And the moment the Rasagulla lands on the tongue, immediately mouth, eyes, everything closes. Be attentive. What happened? The division between the Sat and the Chit is zero. They have become one. Whenever Sat and Chit are separate, it is samsara. When Sat and Chit, they are not separate, it is Paramatma. It is that experience where experiencer is not born. It is that knowledge where knower is not born. Once I was going from London to Mumbai, and you know, these days because of this IT, the children give their parents gift, go to Europe. Coming from lower middle class family, they have never gone out of Jhumri Talaiya, but now their children have got lot of money. So they want to give something. Earlier they used to give one t-shirt or one handkerchief. But now they want to give something great to their parents. So they give a vacation to Europe. For the first time they have come out of the Jhumri Talaiya. First time. Like that, when I was going, a group of such people, I was standing near the restroom in the flight and stretching my limbs. One gentleman came and asked me, excuse me, are you Swami? This was his posture. Are you Swami? I said, any objection? No, are you Swami? So I thought, you know, he's getting into the circle. So I kept quiet. He looked behind. His wife, Akho Akho Me. He don't know even how to talk. Come here. And poor obedient husband went back. And then she came. Excuse me. I said, excuse it. They know I am Indian. I know English, Hindi, local language. Excuse me. Do you know Swami Anubhavananda? He looks like you. Then I said, yes, no. Yes, no? I said, yes. How come yes, no? Because I know, therefore yes. But I don't know him as you know him, someone other than you. If I ask you a question, do you know yourself? Yes, no. You know. But do you know as you know something else? How do you know yourself? Through your sense organs? Oh, I have seen myself. No, I smell myself like a dog. No, I can lick myself. How do I know myself? Be attentive. Pramana nirapeksha anubhuti. that experience which does not involve the working of any means of knowledge. Sohamityasam, that is me. Now what will be the spiritual practice? Anything that is recognized through the sense organs, the mind or the intellect, drop it. This is what Bhagavan says. Bheda bhavana sohamityaso bhavana abhida. Abhida, non-differentiated. This experience where there is no otherness. Bhavana abhida pavani mata. That is the ultimate purifying experience of life. See, friends. Now, in this process, anything which will be coming in between, recklessly throw it away. Don't get involved in this world. This world is always like this. There was one person doing his prayers, namaz. He put his towel in a garden and he was standing to do namaz. One girl came. She walked over the towel and went straight away. And this man got very angry, but the girl has gone already. After some time, maybe about an hour or so, he was waiting for her. When she came, he scolded her. You walked over my towel, you bad girl and all that. She said, if I had done that, I am extremely sorry. I had done wrong, I agree. But I didn't realize, because I was so preoccupied to go and see my beloved friend. He was waiting for me. And I just ran through. I didn't recognize that you are here. But if it has happened, I am sorry. But I have got a question. When I was running to see my mortal friend, I did not see anything in this world. How come you are offering the prayer to the Lord and you saw me? See, friends, in Vrindavan, there was a great master, and like we are sitting, satsangis took be there. One lady one day told the Mahatmaji, when everybody has gone, she was sitting with two, three people. Maharaji, you know, in the satsang, when we sit, that one man is constantly looking at me. So the Maharaji is Maharaji. He said, Beta, how do you know he is constantly looking at you unless you constantly look at him? See, friends, nothing in this world can ever attract our mind if you are committed to the truth. See? Don't worry about this world. The world has been always been like this. Nothing new. And we have not created the world. Why worry? And Bhagavan clearly says in Bhagavad Gita, Uddhared Atmanatmanam Natmanam Avasadayat. You are in this world for your evolution. But then what about the world? Bhagavan has said very clearly. If Bhagavan was Bengali, how Bhagavan will say? Jodha jodha hi dhormasya glani bhavati bharato. Yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyutthanam dharmasya tadatmanam srujamyam. When there is a need, I'll come. You don't worry. Take care of yourself. See? Therefore, bhavana abhida pavani mata. Then, bhava shunya sat bhava sastiti hi. Next step. Here the Buddhists get lost. Bhava shunya. There is nothing. And therefore, in the nihilist philosophy of Buddhism, they say nothingness is everything. See? Bhagavan says, bhava shunya sad bhava. Be attentive. That which is present in the absence is beyond presence and absence. Sound is present. Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. Why this has become three times? Because in between two Om Namah Shivaya, there is absence of the sound. Om Namah Shivaya, absence of sound. Om Namah Shivaya, absence of sound. How are we able to count it three? Because we are both, whether there is a sound or there is the absence of sound, we are a continuous presence. Waking comes and goes. We don't come and go anywhere. Dream comes and goes. We don't come and go anywhere. Deep sleep comes and goes. We are the same. Samadhi begins and ends. We never end. All the experiences come and go. We have not come. We are not gone. Like the sky. The dark clouds come, rain go away. The sky doesn't become wet because of the rains. Then the white clouds come, make a lot of noise. Because of that, the sky doesn't get disturbed. Then there is pitch darkness, night. Sky doesn't get influenced by the darkness. Sometime there is a summer cloud-free blue sky. It is not an achievement for the sky. Exactly the same way. Waking is like the clouds raining. Dream is like the clouds thundering without rains. Deep sleep is like the darkness. A samadhi is like the blue sky. It makes no difference. Is it not our experience? You don't have to do anything. Only just be aware of this, what you are. Then the disease of doing something or the other will disappear. See? And because this doesn't disappear, then let us do meditation. Swamiji, can you please teach me meditation? Okay. Cut the onion. See? Meditation is not done. Dhyan karte nahi, dhyan dete. What do you say? Be attentive. We don't say, do attentive. Attention is made available. Therefore, bhava shunya sad bhava susthitihi, that which is recognized even in the absence. And for this, I'll give you two techniques. I am promising you, you will never do it. But I'll tell you. Listen to silence. Now see what is happening. Ears can hear only sounds. Ears cannot hear the silence. But we do experience silence. Then how to listen to silence? Be indifferent to the sounds. See. Now the sounds are absent. This absence of sound is also illuminated by us, the eternal presence. So whether you want or you don't want, You are divine. You don't have to become divine. Therefore, bhava shunya sad bhava susthitihi. That which is supporting the absence is beyond the presence and absence. That which is supporting the presence and absence is not influenced by both of them. And it is our natural state. We don't have to do anything, my friends. Like our eyes. Now my eyes are seeing her red shirt, then blue one, then green, then white. Are my eyes influenced by any color? They are supporting every color. The rule is, the illuminator is not influenced by what is illumined. See, you don't have to do anything. Minds are not influenced by any thought. Let there be good thought, bad thought. Mind is mind. But we insist, there should be only good thoughts. There is nothing like good thoughts, bad thoughts. Thoughts are thoughts. But when you hold on to the mind, thoughts will become important. Go one step further. We support waking, dream, deep sleep, samadhi. Nobody is attached to the body. If you are attached to body, you will never go to sleep. But we are so anxious to go to sleep, even in the satsang. See? The rule is, we are unattached. Attachment is an illusion. This is what Bhagavan says in Bhagavad Gita. Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam charanam raja. Give up everything. What he means, before you give up everything, find out what is yours. Can I give divorce to your wife? Swamiji, my wife is troubling me too much. What should I do? Okay, don't worry. I'll give her divorce. Sorry. Now what can you give up in this world? What is yours? Start from your own body. So when it is said, give up everything, means come to realize nothing is yours. See, my friends, with this wisdom, with this understanding, when we live our life, it is called a spiritual life. Otherwise, tabla peti bajate raho, nothing will happen. So, bhavana balad bhakti ruttama. Then, by the strength of this bhavana, be attentive. Bhavana is not imagination. Dr. Singh asked me this question. See, imagination is, we imagine, I wish I go to Alaska. It's a beautiful place. I don't know when will I go. It's imagination. See, I am at peace with myself. This is not imagination, this is experience. Bhavana leads to experience. Imagination leads to fantasies. Bhavana balad. Be attentive. Now our bhavana is, I am the body. Even if God comes and tells us, you are not the body, we say, come on, yaar, dusra kuch ko. We are so convinced. The same intensity of conviction by which we call ourselves to be the body, with the same intensity of conviction, when we are able to drop this body identification, then the truth is revealed. See? To know the gold in an ornament, is it necessary to melt the ornament? To know the space in a pot, and the total space is one, is it necessary to break the pot? Think. External air and internal air, are they separate? One. External space, internal space, are they separate? One. Where is the otherness? See, friends, therefore Bhagavan says here, Bhavana Balad, when you thus practice this. And what is the practice? Number one, don't talk differences. Number two, don't support differences. Number three, don't justify differences. Number four, don't promote differences. Discover the common denominator. What are the differences? Jiva Jagat Ishvara. Papoham Papakarmaham. You are not a sinner. You are divine. That one reality with the conditioning of the names and forms is called as Jagat. The same reality with the conditioning of the Panchakoshas is called as Jiva. The same reality with the conditioning of the Maya is called as Ishvara. Like, be attentive. Like, I, with the conditioning of my father, I am called as a son. The same I, with the conditioning of my wife, I am called as the husband. The same I, with the conditioning of my son, I am called as the father. Have I become three? I am only one. And who is miserable? These three fellows. The son is miserable because of the Hitler father. The husband is miserable because of the Mahakali. And the father is miserable because of the monster son. Man is happy. Where are these three fellows? These non-existing entities, they are becoming miserable. Therefore, Bhavana Balad Bhakti Uttama, the real devotion. See, the ultimate in devotion is knowledge, and the ultimate in knowledge is devotion. They are not two. See, with this training, we train our mind how to think. See, we have to think, we have to learn how to think. But normally what happens? Common thing, because there are thoughts in our mind, we imagine I am a thinker. Instead of complaining about the thoughts, instead of complaining about the mind, what Arjuna did, when Bhagavan said, Atma Pammena Sarvatra Samam Pashyati Arjuna Sukham Vajariva Dukkham Sayogi Paramomataha. Equanimity is the supreme attainment in yoga. Arjuna says, Yoyam Yogas Tvaya Proktaha Samyena Madhusudana Tasyaham Pashyami Chanchalatva Stidim Siram. What you are talking about equanimity, I don't think it is possible at all. Because Chanchalam Hi Manat Krishna Pramati Balavadrudam. Mind is so unsteady, very firm, very obstinate, and very powerful. How to control that mind? I don't think it is possible. Complaints. Bhagavan says, possible. Abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagyena cha guriyate. You start inquiring. Whenever you are disturbed, at the root of every disturbance, there is somebody. That's it. And then find out, is that somebody real? Then let that somebody do his job. See? One day, one man came to me and he was talking about his wife. Amiji, don't make fun of me. I said, no, you are self-sufficient. I don't need to make fun. You know, I am so disturbed because of my wife. She doesn't understand. She is so dumb. I said, look here. I agree with you. She is dumb. You also agree? I said, yes. Unless she is dumb, she will not marry you. She has married you is a very clear indication she has to be dumb. No, Swamiji, you are again making fun of me. What should I do? Please tell me. I said, okay, listen. Now answer my questions. Don't argue. Yes. Husband is a proper noun or a common noun? You are taking me to the grammar school. I said, yes, grammar school. Husband is a common noun or proper noun? Of course, it is a common noun. Common noun means what? It is common. Any fool married to any fool is called as husband, is it not? Common noun. So every husband is miserable. What is new if you are miserable? Common noun. Don't take life too seriously. Adjust yourself. Life is 100% adjustment. You have to adjust at every moment. See? And that experience is needed for our evolution. Every experience is required for our evolution. See? Near Hyderabad, in the outskirts, there are very huge, huge stones. Not mountains, but big, big stones are there on hillocks. One day, one sculptor went and he was looking here and there and he saw one beautiful big stone, big rock rather. And then he had in his mind, so he has drawn something and started with the chisel and hammer hitting and removing the things. And then he'll go back. Again next day he will come. Again he will start. That time that big rock which was hit by the chisel and hammer, he used to pray to the Lord, oh Lord, see other rocks are so lucky. Nobody disturbed them. This fellow comes every morning. Oh. Lord didn't stop. It continued. A beautiful idol of the Lord came out of that rock. It was lifted. Installed prana pratishtha, and millions of people will come and do namaskar. That time, that rock in the form of the god says, oh sculptor, thank you very much. Other rocks are lying there only. Friends, every difficulty, every problem in our life is for our evolution. It is necessary. All unwanted things are rejected. We have to throw them away. Otherwise, we will be all the time only complaining. A spiritual seeker never complains. Spiritual seeker is like the waters. It happened here only, one of the places I don't remember. One amma used to bring food for me, where I was staying. And she had a son. So one day the son also came. And there was something wrong with his, so he was fighting with his mother and crying non-stop. And she was saying, okay. And she was hitting the food and giving me. And this fellow was constantly crying. I felt like giving him one. But then I remembered 911. So I kept quiet. See, one and again the 911 is terrible, isn't it? So I said, no more. Then how to deal with, you can imagine, you are sitting for food and somebody is constantly crying. Now his mother brought food, I can't do anything also. Survival. So I said, let me talk to him. I said, hey, these ice cubes I want to put into this bottle, a jar it was there, and they are not going all inside. What should I do? Please tell me. Should I break the jar, put them and then unite the jar? In that crying also, he laughed. This is not the way. What is the way? you just put it there and don't do anything. But then how it will accommodate? Don't do anything. You tell me how. After some time, the ice will melt, it will become water, it will accommodate. Don't worry. And crying stool. Wisdom giving to others. But he was still crying. That day he was my great guru. We are like ice cubes. Therefore, I versus you. Don't touch me. But when all these names and forms are dissolved, we are all one. Ice cubes and water, they are not two. In the same manner, man and husband, they are not two. Man, given the shape, is called as husband. The day we discover this, multiplicity is on account of the upadhi, the conditioning. Space is one. That one space is made into 10. North, east, west, south, four corners, 8, up and down, 10. How this one space has become 10? Because of the upadhi, the conditioning of relationship between the sun and the earth. If you go away from the conditioning of sun and the earth relationship, then whether you are in the south or the north. Friends, in the infinite, fractions are imagined. Infinite cannot be divided. Infinite cannot be multiplied. We can only imagine. Like we imagine the 10 directions in the space. See? Thus, when we go beyond the conditioned expressions of the Absolute, we have discovered the truth. After this discovery, then yogaratova, bhogaratova, sangaratova, sangavihinaha, yasya brahmani ramate chittam, nandati 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 eva, bhajagovindam, bhajagovindam. We don't have to prove anything to anybody. We don't have to be someone extraordinary. We have to drop all the extra. Be ordinary. Spiritual evolution is not becoming someone extraordinary. Are we carrying less burden of the extra on our head? I am man, I am woman, I am young, I am old, I am Gujarati, I am a Bengali. In addition to that, I am spiritual. Just be. And therefore, if somebody is walking the path properly, the symptoms are, he is insult-proof. He doesn't want to prove anything to anybody. Like a child. Child doesn't want to prove anything to anybody. Child is like that. When he is in a mood, he will talk to him. Our struggle is this. Therefore, bhavana balad bhakti uttama. By this bhavana, by this practice, we attain the ultimate in devotion. Thereafter, the teacher continues. So, what are the paths in spiritual evolution? Rustale manaha, swasthata kriya, bhakti yoga bodhascha nishchitam. So, whether it is karma yoga, bhakti yoga, or Jnana Yoga or the Ashtanga Yoga, all of them have the same goal, same destination. And destination is Manaha Rustale Swasthata. Mind must come back to its source. Sorry. Hridaya, this word means Ru Harati, the one which loots away, which takes away. Everything is taken away when it goes back. Like waves are taken away by the ocean, ocean is taken away by the waters. This journey from the manifest to the unmanifest is the spiritual path. See? Hristale manaha sastata kriya. And it is for this purpose, these three things are told in our scriptures. Karma yog, yoginaha karma kurvanti sangam tyaktva atma shuddhai. For the purification of the mind, karma is done. Not for gaining something or protecting something. Then bhakti yog, the path of devotion, is not for going and asking from the Lord. Our devotion is not a devotion, it is a bargain. See, during the examination time, Hanumanji is having, you know, overtime job. All the students go there with a coconut. Therefore, Hanumanji has got the bat, mace. If I pass, I will do this, I will do that. Our devotion is only a bargain. It is not devotion. We go there with a, therefore, longer the namaskar. Some people do namaskar for a long time. Are utho? Wait a minute, wait a minute. What is the reason some people do such a long namaskar? 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 4 minutes, 5 minutes. List is very long. Oh, Bhagwan, do this, 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 and they get up. How many things are we going to ask from him? And that is why all our gods have got this mudra. You have seen, isn't it? This is Abhaya mudra, technically called as, and this is Dana mudra. But this is not the real meaning. Real meaning is, Bhagwan says, enough, how much will you ask? And this is, if you don't stop, I'll give you one. See? Constantly asking, asking, how much you ask. See? The devotion is for merging ourselves. Be attentive. A person who is engaged in yoga, tapasya and karma, their eye becomes very strong. I am not like others. I have taken care of this. I have done like this. I. To remove this poison of I, devotion begins. In devotion or upasana, I is surrendered. Then comes the yogabhyas. In yogabhyas, we have to discipline our mind. So first, well, define the I. Who is this I? So I am mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife. Then do those duties sincerely. And when you are busy in doing your duty sincerely, you don't have extra time to loiter around in the world. Because you are busy. See? Then the second thing. When we just do the life, then slowly, slowly, we start developing our very strong personality. And see, this ego is like the Musca domestica. You know Musca domestica? The house fly is entomologically called as Musca domestica. So, Musca domestica, the house fly, has no discrimination. It can go and sit anywhere. Whether it is the dirty thing, it will go and sit on there. Whether there is a prasad of the Lord, it will go and sit over there. No discrimination. In the same manner, this ego has no discrimination. I have a lot of money. I have earned it day and night I have worked. Ego with lot of money. I don't have money. I am not rich like you. I am a poor. Both of the conditions are the limitations of the money. One is having I because lot of money. Other is having I because of no money. See, there are two types of miseries in life. One type of misery is called as miseries of having, and second is miseries of not having. Those who don't have children, they are miserable because they don't have children. Those who have children, they are more miserable. Misery is common for both. See? Therefore, when we remove this I, or we want to remove this I, we bring an element of devotion. One child asked me this question many years before. Swamiji, you tell us, whenever something good happens, God's grace. Why God's grace? If something bad happened, we should say God did it. Why we should take the responsibility? I said, okay, listen. When something bad happens, what we do? We are expert in blaming others for our problems. This is our default settings. If I am a husband, cause of my misery is my wife. If I am a father, cause of my misery is my children. Very easy. Now the scriptures warn, first, stop blaming others. You are responsible for your life. Nobody can make you miserable. Nobody can make you happy. You are self-sufficient in both the conditions. So, first step. So, attention is now drawn away from yourself, to yourself. Second thing, when something good happens, then why bring the God? By God's grace it has happened. Because it is easier to digest failures in life. It's very difficult to digest perpetual success in life. See, when success keeps on piling, konyasti sadrusho maya yakshe dasyami modishe, and therefore we attribute all the success to the divine grace. The net result is we don't blame others for our miseries, and we don't claim everything is happening because of I, because of some factor called as God. The net result will be, we will be at peace. This is the way to dissolve the ego. And therefore, when the ego is dissolved, the truth is revealed. Therefore, all the spiritual practices are bringing the mind back to the source. Hristhale manaha swastata kriya. See, you see the background behind me and experience, where are you? Your experience is you are away from yourself. Now, take away your vision from the background, bring it on my beautiful face. Now you have come relatively closer to you. Now try to see your own eyes with your own eyes. Can you see? You cannot. In the same manner, instead of complaining about the mind, find out that mind which is giving us trouble. What is that mind? See, this is the Ramana way of dissolving the mind in consciousness. And for that, we have to have self-control. And the self-control is done through the yoga abhyas. And what is that? It is the next topic. We'll take it in our next class. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om ஸ்ரீ குருப்யோ நமஹ. ஹரி ஓம்.